Hello everyone, welcome to the collaborative and learning session of oral and maxillofacial surgery. Myself Rutuja Sopan Muthe. Today I am going to talk about dental management in patients suffering from HIV, guided by Dr. Bhushan Bhagat. So HIV, what is HIV? HIV is a human immunodeficiency virus. It is an RNA virus that attacks the body's immune system. If HIV is not treated, it can lead to AIDS, that is acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. It is a retrovirus which depends on enzyme reverse transcriptase to replicate within the host cells. It chiefly multiplies in the CD4 lymphocyte, leading to decrease in the number of CD4 cells. The decrease in CD4 cells leads to decrease in the immunity. It is usually transmitted via direct absorption of body fluids, including blood, semen, vaginal secretions, cerebrospinal fluids, synovial fluids, pleural fluids, pericardial fluids, peritoneal fluids, and saliva. Dental healthcare workers are at a great risk of being infected with HIV. Clinical stages of HIV are, there are total 4 stages of HIV. In stage 1, patient is asymptomatic with persistent generalized lymphadenopathy. In stage 2, patient is mildly symptomatic with unexplained moderate weight loss, herpes zoster, angular cheilitis, recurrent oral ulceration, papular pleuritic eruptions, fungal nail infection, and recurrent respiratory infections. In stage 3, patient is moderately symptomatic with weight loss greater than 10%, chronic diarrhea, persistent fever, oral candidiasis, oral hairy leukoplakia, severe bacterial infection, that is pneumonia, acute necrotizing ulcerative stomatitis. In stage 4, patient is severely symptomatic with pneumocystis pneumonia, extrapulmonary tuberculosis, HIV encephalopathy, chronic herpes simplex infection, esophageal candidiasis, Kaposi's sarcoma, and cytomegalovirus infections. Some oral manifestations of HIV are, first, Kaposi's sarcoma, which is seen as a bluish red bumps in the mouth. Herpes simplex, it is characterized by tiny fluid-filled lesions called cold sores around the lips. ANUG, that is acute necrotizing ulcerative gingivitis, is a severe inflammation of gums characterized by pain, bleeding, and ulceration of interdental papillae. Sjögren's syndrome. It is an autoimmune disease characterized by dry eyes and dry mouth. Hairy leukoplakia. It is seen as a corrugated or hairy appearance on the side of the tongue. Gingival ulcer. It is associated with severe pain and bleeding. And candidiasis. It is characterized by white patches on tongue, buccal mucosa, etc. It is also associated with soreness and loss of taste. Now, diagnosis in HIV. Some investigations to be done are ELISA test, Western blot test, detection of p24 antigens, detection of HIV proviral DNA, nucleic acid test, CD4 T cell count, CBC, that is complete blood count, LFT, that is liver function test, blood urea, blood sugar, and serum amylase. Management of HIV infection is done by detailed history. It starts with asking questions mainly about occupation, mode of infection, fever, weight loss, etc. Counseling. Patient need counseling so as to able to cope up with stress. Prevention of spread of infection. Patient should be advised to refrain from donating blood. Antiretroviral therapy. This therapy increases the CD4 count. Asymptomatic HIV positive patient with CD4 count more than 500 cells per microliter can undergo any dental treatment. And symptomatic patient with CD4 count less than 200 microliters should only undergo emergency surgery after antibiotic prophylaxis. Some protocols for dental treatment are annual routine dental checkup, oral prophylaxis, that is plaque control and scaling, annual radiographic assessment, management of fungal, bacterial, viral and other lesions, management of xerostomia by greater liquid intakes and xylitol chewing gum, treatment of cellulitis and osteomyelitis with penicillin 2 gram per day for 5 to 10 days and metronidazole 400 mg at 8-hour interval. Complex periodontal surgery should be postponed if CD4 count is less than 200. Complex prosthodontic treatments like FPDs implants can be given if CD4 count is greater than 200. And simple prosthodontic treatments like RPD and complete denture can be given to patients with CD4 count less than 200. Assess the risk of septicemia, estimate hemostasis status, estimate CD4 count, CD8 count, platelet and RBC count. Some precautions to be taken during dental surgery are: posting of the patient should be at the end of the operating list. Patient should be induced with general anesthesia in the operation theater, or non-essential items should be removed. Operating table should be covered with waterproof sheet. Disinfectants like 2% glutaraldehyde and 1% hypochlorite solution should be available. Bed kit, that is, which includes plastic apron, eye protectors, mask, and gloves, should be worn by the operator. Non-essential personnel should not be admitted inside the operating room during surgery. If spillage or body fluid occurs, then it should be covered with 1% sodium hypochlorite for 30 minutes and then should be mopped using gloves and old linen paper towels. After the surgery, the operating room and instrument should be cleaned thoroughly. Avoid needle stick injury during surgery. Post-exposure prophylaxis, that is PEP. Firstly, management of wound should be done by wound, that is needle stick injury, should be washed with soap and water and should be irrigated with saline. An antiseptic agent can be applied. Determine the risk associated with exposure. Exposure that require PEP and exposure that do not require PEP. In exposure that require PEP is parenteral or mucous membrane exposure from body fluids like blood, semen, bloodstain, saliva, CSF, etc. Exposure that do not require PEP is when exposed individual is HIV positive and source is HIV negative. Exposure to body fluids that do not pose risk are tears, saliva, urine, and sweat. Exposure to intact skin, infectious fluids. Some PEP regimens are tenofovir 300 mg plus lamivudine 300 mg plus efavirenz 600 mg once daily for 28 days should be administered. In case of patient intolerant to efavirenz, protease inhibitor should be administered. Time to start PEP is preferably within 1 to 2 hours of exposure, and duration of the prophylactic treatment is 4 weeks. These are some references: S.M. Balaji, Textbook of Oral and Maxillofacial Surgery; Anil K. Tripathi, Essentials of Medicine for Dental Students; Hindavi, International Journal of Dentistry; and Surgical Das, Textbook of Surgery. Thank you.